Hello. In this video, I will show you how to find a reduction formula for an integral and then use that reduction formula to evaluate an integral such as I2. These questions normally involve using integration by parts to reduce IN into another integral in terms of IN minus 1 or IN minus 2. That means when you're doing your integration by parts, you want to differentiate the thing with the N in it. Let's do that. We will first of all suppose n is greater than or equal to 1. I want my n to be, well, typically not 0. Then I'll let u equal to x to the n, so the thing I differentiate in my integration by parts is going to be x to the n. My u v dash, the thing I integrate in my integration by parts, will be everything else, so 1 on square root of 1 plus x. That means u dash is equal to n x to the n minus 1, and v is equal to 2 root 1 plus x. Excellent. I have all the ingredients for integration by parts. Then IN can be rewritten as uv, with my limits over there, minus the integral 0, 1, of u dash v dx. And we might mention that this is by parts, which I just throw in my uv, u dash, and v. This is u is x to the n, v is 2 root 1 plus x, 0, 1, minus the integral 0, 1, u dash, n x to the n minus 1, and v is 2 root 1 plus x dx. So I can expand this out. I'll rewrite this as 2 root 2, so that's the first bit, minus 2n the integral 0 to 1 of x to the n minus 1 square root 1 plus x dx. Which is not exactly what I wanted. I wanted something of the form IN minus 1. And I've got the N minus 1, but I don't have the denominator as it should be. So I'll put that denominator in, 1 plus X, and I might square this term over here, that. Good. So I can rewrite that as 2 root 2 minus 2N times by integral from 0 to 1 of x to the n minus 1 on square root 1 plus x dx, plus another integral, that is the integral from 0 to 1 x to the n on square root 1 plus x dx. And we recognize these two integrals. This is IN minus 1, this is IN, and recall this whole thing was equal to IN. So we have an expression for IN in terms of IN and IN minus 1. IN is 2 root 2 minus 2N IN minus 1 plus IN. And we can rearrange this as IN is equal to 2 root 2 minus 2N IN minus 1 divided by 1 plus 2n. And we have a reduction formula for IN. And remember our assumption at the start that n was greater than or equal to 1, so we should probably mention that. N greater than or equal to 1. Excellent. Let's use this reduction formula to evaluate I2. Now we have our reduction formula, let's use it to find I2. This reduction formula only works for n greater than or equal to 1, so we need somewhere to start. And we typically start with I0 or I1, that will depend on the question. In this case, I0 is easy to evaluate. I0 is the integral from 0 to 1 of x to the 0, so I'll just write that as 1, of the square root of 1 plus x dx, which we can evaluate. That's the integral of 2 square root 1 plus x, 0 to 1, which is, well, when x is 1, that's 2 root 2 minus
minus epsilon.
Good, we evaluated I0. We can use I0 and our reduction formula to build up more integrals.
Such as I1. Using our reduction formula, we know that I1 is equal to 2 root 2 minus 2 times 1, so I'll just leave that as 2, I0 divided by 1 plus 2. So that's 2 thirds root 2 minus I0 which is equal to, well, let's leave that as 2 thirds root 2 minus 2 root 2, so that's negative root 2, and minus minus 2 is plus 2. Good. I1. And finally, I2. Well, that's, according to our reduction formula, equal to 2 root 2 minus 4 I1 divided by 5. So I'll write that as 2 fifths times root 2 minus, well, I1 was this, so that's 4 thirds times 2 minus root 2, which we can write as 2 fifteenths times by 3 root 2, minus 8 plus 4 root 2. So maybe I'll change that to a 7 root 2. Good. I2. And this is the way I'd encourage you to apply your reduction formula. Start off with something which is known and then gradually build up the integral. Thank you.